Dr. Jordan Hochman is an otologic and neurologic surgeon at the Health Sciences Center in Winnipeg. Since he was in residency, he has always been interested in issues involving the ear.
I thought it was really interesting. It's a very busy piece of anatomy. All the important structures are encased in bone, which is different than many other disease sites in the body. So a lot of the dissection and work you do in the operative theater is undertaken with a surgical drill, which is different than when you work with soft tissues.
Dr. Hochman is the surgical lead of the adult cochlear implant program.
There's been an incredible amount of innovation that has taken place over the last number of years. We're very privileged here at the Health Science Center that we have now started a cochlear implant program and we've been running for 3 years now. And this is a very unique technology. It takes individuals who are entirely deaf, someone who will not benefit with a conventional hearing aid, and allows them to have sound awareness and open word discrimination. So it's very powerful, and it really influences or has a very large impact on the quality of an individual's life. And this is truly a bionic ear. It is a computer that we are inserting into someone's skull and directly passing an electrode along the eighth cranial nerve, the nerve of hearing, to provide them direct stimulation of that nerve.
When Dean Bryant was 4 years old, he lost his hearing as a result of a viral infection. He was able to function quite well with hearing aids until 2012, when one day, while at work, he suddenly became completely deaf.
My hearing all of a sudden just like went kaput. I couldn't hear nothing. Like it was very minuscule what I heard. It was very low. So I thought my hearing aid was not working or my battery went dead.
So now you've had this shock, and I can tell that at the time it was really shocking for you, very traumatizing for you.
It was like he had died, because Dean is a very active person. He loves to talk, he loves to socialize. He was a very hard worker, and then when he went deaf, he stopped everything, and he just sat there. It was very hard for me.
When I went back to work and they were accommodating me, I was couldn't work alone. I had certain restrictions, and it was good of them to bring me back to work. You know, it's better than sitting in the house all day thinking about this, but it was just, I spent all day reading lips, so when I got home, I was mentally exhausted. And so I just sat down on the couch, I turned the TV on, I watched the caption. I didn't want to talk to my kids, I didn't want to talk to my wife, really.
It was hard to communicate.
You know? Can you take me through how your life has changed since you received the implant?
It's life-changing, really. I mean, from the time where he was deaf to now, it made him more disabled. Now he's who he was when I met him. Like, without your hearing, it's like being blind again. You can't, you're only limited to do certain things.
Sounds like you got your husband back.
Yeah, exactly. That's right.
I can stick it off, just a magnet holds it.
There's a magnet here and there's a magnet inside
like
of his head.
Anything magnetic, it'll attach to. So I have an implant inside my head, this titanium, or whatever, and some kind of metal. And so this is just a magnet, like if it's like that.
It stays.
Same thing.
Magnet, yeah. And then
so
he has...
Actually, if I get working near something that's got metal, like one day I was working under my truck and all of a sudden my hearing disappeared. I wondered what the heck happened. And my hearing aid was gone. It was stuck in the frame of my truck. So that's what this did.
A lot of the people that you're performing this surgery on have never heard anything ever in their life.
There's a huge spectrum. Most of the individuals who are adults are people who have had excellent hearing and then lost it for a number of different possible reasons. And then the children, the kids, unfortunately most of them are people who didn't have sound awareness initially. So there's a big spectrum there.
Once the implant is in place, it takes time, training, and a lot of practice to get to the quality of sound and understanding that Dean has achieved.
It's not nearly normal hearing. But people can have a conversation without the use of lip reading. So they are able to entirely hear words. It takes time to become a good cochlear implant user, and it's a lot of work. And the exceptional audiologists at Central Speech and Hearing Clinic here in Manitoba are the ones who help patients on their journey from silence to sound. And they really do great work.
Can you tell me a little bit about how you feel about Dr. Hochman?
He's been very helpful and supportive of us all the way, so it's been good. I remember the first time I walked in his office after he came for my yearly checkup, he wasn't even looking at me and he says, what's the weather like out today? And he had this book in front of his face and he was tired. He said something about weather. And he says, he was checking up. And
he's very caring and kind and genuine.
So the field is certainly evolving. And historically, one implant was provided to patients. Then children were provided with both ears being implanted so they could actually have binaural stimulation, which improves their word understanding. And now we're moving to a place where adults can start looking potentially at bilateral implantation, as well as situations where there might be some residual low frequency hearing loss. We can do a very delicate insertion and still preserve some of those low frequencies. And that's brand new, and it's exceptionally exciting.